in a few weeks, I will get time to realize it's right before my eyes and I can take it.
Oh, he just starts it up with some punches, and oh, we might have a really quick one here. Is Nick Wu even there? He's gonna turn it around. Nick Wu, buddy?
Oh!
No!
Liquid. They're gonna go at it again. Nick Wu gets the worst of the start, and Liquid might be able to do it here. Nick Wu on his Q. Hughes comes up, misses it, whips it wide. Nick Wu does the same. Nico.
This just hits mega.
Waiting for the cooldown. Nick Wu going.
He's. He's already behind his tower. Should have just recall and come back to play with full health. So drinking a potion.
Don't worry about
either
it.
One of these guys could have done that.
Started off with a ward, as you do. And they're not done.
Oh, they're going again. They don't want to wait.
Nick Wu comes away with it. They're 35 in. Nick Wu evens it up 1-1.
And so he's now tweeted out, that someone please teach me how to read.
That is impressive. They're going to fight it out. They both just stand through auto-attacking as they please. Q's going to land there. Nick Wu takes it 2-1 at a minute and a half again. So the official shortest set. Hope difference is working here with the more sort of standard Red Elixir versus the Dorn Toy.
It's going to be interesting to watch. They do both have exhaustive ignite, so there's so much all-in potential very, very early on. If anybody lets their health dip too low, they could fall prey to that fast sonic wave, followed up with a double summoners.
So, Smithy keeping it in there, though. He's going to have the regen that's a little bit better. Okay. Exhaust comes down, but Cutie Pie doesn't get much out of it, then whiffs the Q. That's a big summoner spell gone with both still left on Smithy, and the burst damage he's going to be able to lay down. I'm a Cutie Pie losing a trade there. Ignite comes out. He's got the red elixir going. Can't he get over to him? Exhaust is there. Cutie Pie hops back in, trying to juke. Can't do it. Smithy first game in 3 minutes 40 seconds. Nicely handled right there as...
At this point, I'm a Cutie Pie is just stepping forward, and Smithy's just immediately backing away. It's like, nope, I want nothing to do with this. Just safeguard the knockout. And Smithy is the one to make an adaptation this time around. He's actually opted for a more impressive turn page. He's taking Lifesteal Quince instead of the experience gain. So looking for a little bit more sustain when he goes in for these kinds of trades. But Cutie Pie's got the level advantage. Once again, the exhaust is burned.
Out and back in. Smithy in. Gets his exhaust in good. And I'm a Cutie Pie with nowhere to run. Ignites there. It's going to be the Tempest that drops him. Then Smithy takes it in 2 straight games.
Mega was a little fortunate there. If Nathaniel B had stepped forward, he could have gotten in range to actually cancel that recall. And if he had delayed Mega Zero's back, this entire wave would have gone down. Nathaniel B would have had an absolutely huge advantage.
He's playing it nice so far, as Mega Zero has been on the back foot just a little bit. That red elixir to answer it back might be enough. He's going to have an extra about a minute and a half. Maybe 2. Nathaniel B not going to need it, though, as Mega Zero just punches him to death.
To have an ultimate at all, because those XP quints gave Mega Zero that window where he hit level 6 first. So basically he got a quarter of that cooldown for free, and Nathaniel B trying to bring it back out, but not having that much success as he trades, pretty much evenly. Mega Zero with some sustain left to spare.
Yeah, got health potions there, the ward down for Nathaniel B, and basically Mega Zero just gonna stay forward on the lane. To his detriment though, as Nathaniel B gets the better of the trade. But again, he's got regen to spare, so he can afford to lose these trades. And Nathaniel B gonna get the worst of that one. Pop summoner heal, barriers gone, and boom, Mega Zero takes care of business. 2-0.
He's just right clicking these trades back down and getting so much health back. Dyrus at that point is essentially a stunned target. You use somebody, if you use a displacement on somebody and put them into a wall, they're all but stunned. There was nothing Dyrus could have done, and that was definitely high on Ghost's game to win there.
I'm Gosu under the turret, but Dyrus lands a Q, goes back out, and he takes the bait. Yeah. Dyrus gets him under the turret, but the turret didn't care, and I'm Gosu going to take game one.
Someone just finally hit me up with a word here, so shout out to Nubeus for Ricky Gervais, the King of Cringe.
Cringe.
That's what I was trying to put for that cringe. I feel really stupid for not being able to come with that. But anyway, Dyrus and Haim Gosu were hitting each other. We should probably talk about
it. See, I thought it was transmission. Haim Gosu in trouble. Dyrus is just going to take a little nap, and then a lot of flickering, and I think Dyrus did some damage as Haim Gosu runs pretty low and is going to get very much the best of that trade. And not going to stop Q. Dyrus done. He's going to take a powder on that one. We'll go to a game three.
A way to get Dyrus away from him and any hope or prayer of getting back in this game.
Dyrus at this point might be content to wait the other 30 CS. And it's probably, I mean, he's up the full 10 CS, but Haim Gosu is the one trying to force the issue. And every time he does, he comes out further and further behind.
Yeah, just look at the beat up right there. Dyrus under the turret. Exhaust is there. And Dyrus gets out of range, but taken very low by Gosu. He's still a level different on him. Haim Gosu there. Not enough.
You have to make all possible effort to immediately get back into the lane. So, but you're not, like, immediately DQ'd.
Yeah, but it certainly puts you at a tactical disadvantage if you can't use the river or anything like that. That armor coming into play. And ult into Q for Boxbox. Shuts down game one. Mancloud going to lose it.
Yeah, Boxbox is has to feel like he didn't get too far behind. Like, realistically, this is a lot closer than it looks. And Mancloud, yeah, taking two tower shots. Only one tower shot. Still
can he get out? No way out of this one. He barriers up. Might have the time. So close. Right there, Boxbox was burning, and had he gotten him to spin that red elixir earlier, that would have been a man. Can't get in close enough to make sure that line stays over, as he has got such an advantage right now. Beautifully played by Mancloud has put Boxbox up against a wall. He's got him in check, looking for mate.
Yeah, it was a huge play, Mancloud. As soon as he hit level 6, just came in, threw down the ignite, threw down the ultimate, pushed Boxbox out. That red elixir was the only thing that kept him alive. He came out of that with about 80 HP, and he picked up a significantly larger amount of HP than that just from the red elixir. So Mancloud completely dominating the lane right now, up 16 CS. And for a while there, he was just one sonic wave landing away from winning this one. But now Boxbox, as you mentioned, he's got a little bit of regen, but here it is.
Starts it up. The ult in is not good enough to get him out of range for the follow-up Q as Mancloud follows it back in and finishes the set 2-1. Boxbox down to the loser's bracket.
Now those extra offensive stats are going to fall off, and that 350 gold is going to be gone forever. So he needs to take advantage of this timing window and bully Mega Zero out, get a good creep advantage, and just use this time while he has it.
Keeping in mind as well that the first one to 70 CS is going to be the winner if it goes to that end. Estipo doing a nice job of keeping pace here. Mega Zero with a really well-used teleport managed to get himself back and then out to the field before Estipo could do anything, which is basically locking into lane. Estipo on the wrong end of a lot of stuff there. Gonna go ahead and Q over. Doesn't matter that the barrier was there. Mega Zero gonna take game one handily with it. Playing nice there. Estipo noticed it. Mega Zero gonna take the shot and pretty much even there. Estipo gonna be a little bit better looking. Just for the moment, and gonna stick with the Doran's Blade open for Mega Zero, and he might go for it here. Estipo in a little bit of trouble. Is he gonna be able to get out? No!